Hi there. Today I want to do a talk about Joyce Meyer. This is one of the best books I've ever read. It's called Approval Addiction. Joyce is a preacher that has touched lives all over the world. And with so much happening in our lives, I wanted to share a discussion about something she taught and how it has helped me learn that we have to not only forgive, but also move forward despite obstacles. It's called Making Right Choices. Joyce says we have to start making right choices while we are still hurting, which is difficult and painful. Since that is the case, some people never break free. We often have to do the right thing for a long time before we begin getting right results. We must do right and keep doing right, pressing past how we feel about it. For example, treating someone right who has hurt us in the past is emotionally and mentally painful. It seems downright unfair and even like a stupid thing to do. After all, why should we be good to someone who has hurt us? Well, if we cannot find any other reason, we can choose to do it just because Jesus told us to. See Matthew 5:38-44. If someone has hurt me and I am bitter about it, that person is actually still hurting me. Bitterness is a pain in itself. It is a negative attitude that steals joy and peace. However, if I am willing to press past the pain and make a decision to forgive, I will be free. If my husband Dave hurts my feelings or disappoints me in some way, it hurts. As long as I refuse to forgive him, it keeps hurting. As soon as I choose to do what the Bible teaches me to do, which is to forgive and treat him as if nothing happens, I am free. To be free from the pain, I have to press past it. I have to choose to do the right thing while I am still hurting. Let me tell you a story that illustrates this point. The scene is a courtroom trial in South Africa. A frail black woman, about 70 years old, slowly rises to her feet. Across the room and facing her are several white police officers. One of them is Mr. Van der Broek, who has been tried and found implicated in the murders of both the woman's son and her husband some years before. Van der Broek had come to the woman's home, taken her son, shot him at point-blank range, and then set the young man's body on fire while he and his officers partied nearby. Several years later, Van der Broek and his men had returned for her husband as well. For months, she knew nothing of his whereabouts. Then, almost 2 years later, after her husband's disappearance, Van der Broek came to fetch the woman herself. How well she remembers in vivid detail that evening, going to a place beside a river where she was shown her husband bound and beaten, but still strong in spirit, lying on a pile of wood. The last word she heard from his lips as the officers poured gasoline over his body and set him aflame were, "Father, forgive him." Now the woman stands in the courtroom and listens to the confessions offered by Mr. Van der Broek, a member of South Africa's Truth and Reconciliation Commission, turns to her and asks, "What do you want? How should justice be done to this man who has so brutally destroyed your family?" "I want three things," begins the old woman calmly but confidently. "I want first to be taken to the place where my husband's body was burned so that I can gather up the dust and give his remains a decent burial." She paused, then continued, "My husband and son were my only family. I want secondly, therefore, for Mr. Van der Broek to become my son. I would like for him to come twice a month to the ghetto and spend a day with me so that I can pour out on him whatever love I still have remaining in me." She also stated that she wanted a third thing. "This is also the wish of my husband, and so I would kindly ask someone to come to my side and lead me across the courtroom so that I can take Mr. Van der Broek in my arms and embrace him and let him know that he is truly forgiven." As the court assistants came to lead the elderly woman across the room, Mr. Van der Broek, overwhelmed by what he had just heard, fainted. As he did, those in the courtroom, family, friends, neighbors, all victims of decades of oppression and injustice, began to sing softly but assuredly, "Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me." Although it appears that the elderly woman who had endured such a painful loss was doing Mr. Vanderbrook a huge favor, and indeed she was, she actually was doing more for herself than for him. Because of her actions, her past had no authority over her future. She was not allowing the pain of the past to poison her attitude. Her attitude gave God glory. God is not glorified by our suffering, but he is glorified when we have a good attitude during suffering. I am sure the woman had to discipline her feelings. She had to make a right choice that was not easy, but the reward was worth it. She made a right decision while she was still hurting, and the decision contributed to putting an end to her pain. As long as we stay angry, we keep our pain. When we begin to pray for and bless those who have hurt us, the pain is swallowed up in love. As Mahatma Gandhi once said, "The weak can never forgive. Forgiveness is the attribute of the strong." I'm going to share a link to this book below and to Joyce Meyer's ministries. I encourage you to learn about her work and support her for the amazing teaching she does. Whatever you are doing today, I pray for you and thank you for listening.